I am Neha Antal, Assistant Professor, School of Biosciences, IMSUC, Ghaziabad. We have already discussed bacteriophage. Now we will discuss bacteriophage cycle, life cycle, and here we will be discussing lytic cycle. Lytic cycle, as we have studied, in lytic cycle, phage generally acts like a typical virus. It hijacks its host mechanism, host machinery, or host cell, and uses its host resources to make a lot of new virion. Or new, in this case, we will call phages, and causing the cell to lyse, burst, and die in the process. These cycles we can generally see in E. coli bacteria. And E. coli basically cause infection caused by T. phages. The cycle or this process involves five steps, basically adsorption or infection, penetration or injection, synthesis of phage component, virion assembly, lysis or release. Now we will discussing in detail. Lytic cycle, the first step to attachment. Attachment or we can say attachment or we can say adsorption. When bacteriophage comes to in contact with the bacterial cell, there are certain sites present, certain sites or specific receptors are present on bacteria as well as on the structure of bacteriophage. Like here we will be discussing specific receptors on tails. So when those particular receptors get attached with the bacteriophage tail fibers, bacteriophage start landing on the bacterial surface, bacterial cell surface. The first step attachment is comprised of further steps like attach, adsorption, landing, settlement, then also attachment, penetration. When the bacteriophage settle down completely, it starts injecting its genetic material into the bacterial cell. But how? There are certain, like first we will discuss the receptors name. The viral receptors may be F pili, lipoproteins, iron transport proteins, etc. And there are certain specific receptors present on the tip of tail fibers. For example, T4 and T7 coliphages bind to lipopolysaccharides, and in this case, sugar transporter molecule as a receptor is there. After settling, next comes start entry of the genome or penetration or injection. This process, this step works like exactly like injection mechanism. Tail fibers penetrate, bind to the specific receptor. Bacteriophage contracts its contractile sheet, and base pins gets attached to the bacterial cell. Bacterial cells, let I show you the diagram. This one, bacteria is landing with the help of tail fibers get attached to the specific receptor. For example, let me say this is the lipopolysaccharide receptor. Another tail fibers land, it is settled down. This is the outer membrane of bacterial cell, this is the inner membrane bacterial cell, and this is the cytoplasm. See here, base plate tail fibers, this is a tail. Now tail is making a hole in the outer membrane, as by there are certain enzymes present which make a hole, or we can say which loosen the covalent binding of the membrane, through which all these cells get escape and a hole is created. After settling down, the DNA, the genetic material, bacteriophage transfer its genetic material into the bacterial cell. You can see here, this is here, it is creating a hole, and after creating the hole through injection mechanism, it is injecting its DNA into genetic material into the cytoplasm. And when the whole DNA is transferred into the bacterial cell, the left out body is known as host or donut. Now, after injecting of the DNA genetic material or after penetration, fast DNA synthesize early proteins. Some early proteins break down the bacterial DNA and take the control of the bacterial cell machinery, whereas other early proteins use as enzymes for replication of fast DNA. As newly fast DNA produces synthesize fast DNA produces late proteins which form the further subunits like capsid, head and tail. After forming all the particle, assembly process comes in this all the capsid particles arrange and form icosahedral structure or head structure. And first is here, first capsid is formed, and after that genetic material is injected into the capsid one. After the capsid or the assembly of a virus particle takes place, then comes the last step, that is lysis or release. But how it can occur? During the lytic cycle, in the late phases, late proteins are fast expresses certain genes for proteins which pokes hole in the plasma membrane and the cell wall. This hole lets water flow in the cell and making the cell expand and burst like an overfilled water balloon. As after cell bursting or lysis, 100 to 200 progeny virions are released from the bacterial cell and infect, get ready to infect other host cells nearby. In this way, a few cycles of lytic infection can let the phage spread like wildfire through a bacterial population. This is how cycle occur. This is a first diagram. See here, bacterial cell, bacterium, bacterial chromosome. First is attachment. Phage comes and get attached with these specific receptors. Second is entry. Phage DNA injects by its injection mechanism. Then after injecting its DNA replication, protein synthesis takes place. And after early proteins, with the help of early proteins and late proteins, fast DNA copies and capsid proteins are generated. During assembly, newly assembled phage particles are formed, and after that, a hole is created and the phage particles are released from the bacterial cell and kill its host cell. This is the other diagram. First attachment, you can see here, the phage attaches to the surface of the host, then it is penetrating its DNA, fast DNA, host DNA penetration, the viral DNA enters the host cell, then capsid, biosynthesis, fast DNA replicates and fast proteins are made, then maturation, new phage particles are assembled, and then lysis, the cell lysis releasing the newly made phages.